son of a gun. We'll have a big fun on the bayou. Hello, friends and neighbors. This is Curtis Alexander. I'm known as the One Man Country Show. I specialize in old-time traditional country music. I perform my program at church events, private parties, nursing home, cafes. And some of the artists I cover in my program are Jimmy Rogers, the Blue Yodeler, the father of country music, Ernest Tubb, the Texas troubadour, Hank Williams Sr., who's the modern-day father of country music, Merle Haggard, Johnny Cash, and Willie Nelson. I'd like you to view some videos of some of my TV appearances and also a concert that I performed at the Weezer Idaho National Fiddlers Competition. I hope you enjoy the videos. These videos will give you an idea of what my program is all about. There's going to be an email where you can reach me if you want to hire me for one of your events. I look forward to hearing from you. In the meantime, friends and neighbors, be better to your neighbors and you're going to have better neighbors. Doggone you. Okay, here we are again. The first segment of the show, we talked about the evolution of country music, how it was viewed in the 20s as hillbilly music, illegitimate music, and Jimmie Rodgers, the Blue Yodeler, put it on the map, and Hank Williams Sr. took it to the masses with his pop sound and country. We're going to do one style of Hank that made him very popular. It's called a falsetto. That's a half yodel. And he wrote this song, tell a little history behind the song. After one of his many fights with his wife, he was out fishing, and a stranger saw him and could tell that he wasn't paying much attention to fishing. So he said, hey, buddy, did you come here to catch him or watch him swim by? And Hank wrote this song called Long Gone Lonesome Blues. I went down to the river to watch the fish swim by. But I got to the river so lonesome I wanted to die, oh Lord. And then I jumped in the river, but the doggone river was dry. She's long gone, and I am long, lonesome blue. I had me a woman, she wouldn't be true. She made me for my money, and she made me blue. A man needs a woman that he can lean on, but my leaning post is done left and gone. Long gone, and I am long, lonesome blue. I'm gonna find me a river, one that's cold as ice. And when I find me that river, Lord, I'm gonna pay the price, oh Lord. I'm going down in it three times, but Lord, I'm only coming up twice. She's long. Blues boy. Johnny Cash really added a new chapter to country music in 1969 to 71. His TV show brought together all types of people from different genre. James Taylor, Louis Armstrong, Kris Kristofferson, Merle Haggard. And Johnny did a song that was very famous called Folsom Prison Blues.
I hear the train a-coming, it's rolling around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when, but I'm stuck in Folsom Prison, and time keeps dragging on. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Fresno just to watch him die. Kinda changed that a bit. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. I bet there's rich folks eating in a fancy dining car. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. But I know I had it coming, I know I can't be free. But those people keep on moving, and that's what tortures me. Well, if they freed me from this prison and that railroad train was mine, I bet I'd move it on a little further down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I'd let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away. Suey!
There's some people people in Bakersfield, a couple of guys, Merle Haggard and Buck Owens, they added another chapter to country music back in the late 60s and middle 70s, and they didn't have to go to Nashville. They just kept that Bakersfield sound out here and became very popular in Hall of Fame, entered the Hall of Fame. But I'm going to do a couple of Merle Haggard songs. One that put him on the map is called Okie from Muskogee. I like to tell the stories behind these songs, but this was at a time in the country when the country was divided. The hippies were burning the draft cards and the flags, and you have the silent majority people. And Merle was doing a concert in Oklahoma, and they went through Muskogee, and one of the band members said, "Hey, Merle, I bet they don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee." And he wrote this song. It wasn't meant to be released, but the public reacted so well to it, it jump-started his career. Here we go, Okie from Muskogee. We don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee, but we don't take our trips on LSD. We don't burn our draft carts down on Main Street, 'cause we like a living right and being free. But we don't make a party out of loving, but we like holding hands and pitching wool. But we don't let our hair grow long and shaggy like the hippies out in San Francisco do. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee, a place where even squares can have a ball. But we still wave old glory down at the courthouse, and white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. Leather boots are still in style for manly footwear. Beads and Roman sandals won't be seen. Football's still the roughest thing on campus, and the kids here still respect the college dean. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee, a place where even squares can have a ball. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse, by golly, and white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. We still wave old glory down at the courthouse in Muskogee, Oklahoma, USA.
All right, welcome back to Central Valley Buzz, everybody. I'm your host, Chuck Leonard. Who's ready for some live local music?
Yeah.
With me right now, you've seen him here before, one of the most popular musicians that I've ever had on the show, Mr. Cowboy Curtis Alexander. How's it going?
Great, Chuck. Thank you.
Yeah, nice to see you. Now, during the commercial break, we might have got you a gig.
Wow, great.
If you guys are going down to the Fulton Mall for that Rock the Autism show, they had a cancellation. I think we might have filled it with Curtis.
All right.
I think the young people out there, Curtis, would just love the way you play. Now, you play old-time country and western.
Old-time country and western.
Now, why do you play old-time country and western as opposed to the new country?
Because it told more of a story. I thought the substance of the lyrics were a lot better. And I just like that style.
Well, now they're singing style. About badonkadonk and stuff like that. Yeah. I get it.
You can't beat Hank Williams' lyrics, Johnny Cash, Merle Haggard. We're going to feature some Merle Haggard and Buck Owens.
Well, wait a minute. Didn't Merle Haggard just cancel his show here in Fresno because no one bought any tickets?
I didn't hear that.
Yeah, his show is canceled.
Whoa.
Yeah, from low ticket sales.
Wow. Merle's getting up there in age, so maybe he's losing it.
Well, maybe he's just getting a little bit more cantankerous, right?
He's mellowed out more as he got older.
Yes, because he was kind of cantankerous when he was younger.
Cantankerous, spent some time in jail.
Yeah. Wasn't he in jail with Johnny Cash?
No. Well, he was in prison when Johnny Cash came to do a concert.
That's right.
Right. And it changed Merle's life because Merle was going nowhere in prison. And he was so impressed with Johnny Cash, he decided to go straight. And the rest is history.
So Johnny Cash plays a concert in Folsom State Prison. Yeah. Merle Haggard's in there doing some hard time.
This was St. Quentin. So he did, St. Quentin. He did a lot of prisons. Folsom was one of them, but Merle was in St. Quentin.
What was he in there for?
Robbing a liquor store. Attempted robbery.
Did he ever write a song about it?
He wrote a song as a tribute to his mom because she supported him even though he went astray. And we're going to do that song called
Robbed a Liquor Store, so I wrote a story about my mom.
No, but her support. He did more than rob liquor stores. He did
Apparently, she wasn't supporting him enough.
He ran away from home. He did joyriding, but she was still supporting her son no matter what. She's loved him. And when he made it big and set his life straight, he wrote a song as a tribute to him.
And what was that song called?
Mama Tried.
Are you going to do that one
do that one right now.
All right, Cowboy Curtis Alexander, everybody.
First thing I remember knowing was a lonesome whistle blowing and the youngin's dream of growing up to ride. On a freight train leaving town, not knowing where I'm bound, and no one could change my mind but Mama Tried. One and only rebel child from a family meek and mild, my mama seemed to know what lay in store. Despite all my Sunday learning, toward the bed I kept on turning till mama couldn't hold me anymore. And I turned 21 in prison, doing a life without parole. No one could steer me right, but mama tried, mama tried, mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried. Dear old daddy, rest his soul, left my mom a heavy load. She tried so very hard to fill his shoes. Working hours without rest, wanted me to have the best. She tried to raise me right, but I refused. I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but mama tried, mama tried, mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried. Mama tried.
Alexander, do you do home parties or anything?
Yes, local home parties, churches, a lot of church programs for love offering, private parties, cafes.
Because you do a lot of gospel songs,
yeah,
too,
gospel,
right?
Gospel songs, yes.
Some cowboy gospel
Cowboys
songs.
Gospel, country gospels.
Yeah, and so what does it cost to get Cowboy Curtis Alexander over for a night?
Well, $50, but for the churches, that's not much. And then I sell CDs, and
okay.
I have a tip box out.
And a tip box.
Yes, right. Churches, we do a love offering. They pass the collection plate, and then that, and sell my CDs after.
The old, good old love offering.
Love offering, yes.
All right. So, what are you going to do? A gospel song for us now?
Well, let's do one. Okay. Here's one Hank made famous called "From Jerusalem to Jericho." It's about the parable of the Good Samaritans.
Uh-huh.
If anybody knows the Bible, they were despised by the Jews, and then Jesus was saying, "Who is your neighbor?" And the message was, everyone is your neighbor, because all the Jewish people walked past this person who was beaten up and robbed, and it was a Samaritan who came to his aid. So it's called "From Jerusalem to Jericho." From Jerusalem to Jericho, a long and lonely road, a certain man was set up on and robbed of all his gold. They stripped him and they beat him, and they left him there for dead. Who was it then that came along and bathed this aching head? Tell me who, tell me who, tell me who was his neighbor kind and true. From Jerusalem to Jericho, we're traveling every day, and many are the fallen ones that lie along. From Jerusalem to Jericho, a certain priest came by. He heard the poor man calling, but he could not heed his cry. He drew his robes about him, then quickly walked away. Who was it then that came along and ministered that day? Tell me who, tell me who, tell me who was his neighbor kind and true. Traveling every day, and many are the fallen ones that lie along the way. From Jerusalem to Jericho.
Jericho, the wounded man did lay. Along came then a Samaritan who was despised, they say. He ministered unto the man, then he took him in. He paid his fare and told the host, take good care of him. Tell me who. Kind and true. From Jerusalem to Jericho, we're traveling every day, and many are the fallen ones that lie along the way.
All right, Curtis Alexander is here. How you doing, buddy?
Great, good to be back.
Now, you're going to close out the show for us this week with a little bit of good old country music.
Yes, Bakersfield style.
Now, Bakersfield style, you got to be talking about who? Buck Owens?
Buck Owens, Merle Haggard.
Okay, and the first song you're going to be doing for us?
We're going to do Tiger by the Tail.
Ooh, one of my favorite Buck Owens songs.
Yeah, and I want to make one quick note. Last time we mentioned I played churches, private parties, cafes, but I also do mobile homes, mobile park homes, senior homes, and nursing homes.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, Cowboy Curtis Alexander.
Okay, here we go.
I've got a tiger by the tail, it's plain to see. I won't be much when you get through with me. I'm a losing weight and turning mighty pale. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. Well, I thought the day I met you, you were meek as a lamb. Just the kind to fit my dreams and plans. Now the pace we're living takes the wind from my sail. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. I've got a tiger by the tail, it's plain to see. Won't be much when you get through with me. I'm a losing weight and turning mighty pale. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. Well, every night you drag me where the bright lights are found. There ain't no way to slow you down. I'm about as helpless as a leaf in the gale. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. I've got a tiger by the tail, it's plain to see. I won't be much when you get through with me. I'm a losing weight and turning mighty pale. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail. Looks like I've got a tiger by the tail.
All right.
Yeah.
Last time we talked about Merle Haggard being in San Quentin and Johnny Cash influenced him. He was so impressed. And then when Merle started making it big, Johnny heard that Merle was one of the inmates there. And he said, hey, Merle, I like what you're doing. You need to go public. Let them know you were in the big yard because the tabloids are going to eat you up. So do some songs about prison. So Merle took his advice, and you know the rest is history. Here's one called Branded Man. Talks about how difficult it is to get back into society once you get out of prison.
I'd like to hold my head up and be proud of who I am. But they won't let my secret go untold. In the cold. When they let me out of prison, I held my head up high, determined I would rise above the shame. But no matter where I'm living, a black mark follows me. I'm branded with the number on my name. I'd like to hold head up and be proud of who I am, but they won't let my secret go untold. I paid the debt I owed them, but they're still not satisfied. Now I'm a branded man out in the cold. If I live to be 100, I guess they'll never clear my name. 'Cause everybody knows I've been in jail. No matter where I travel, I got to tell them where.
prison if I failed. I'd like to hold my head up and be proud of who I am, but they won't let my secret go untold. I paid the debt I owed them, but they're still not satisfied. Now I'm a branded man out in the cold.
Central Valley Buzz, everybody. And you know, Tattoo, yeah. Have I told you that tequila makes me call collect? don't worry, there's an attorney in the house. Okay. Right. Our guest right now, Cowboy Curtis Alexander, is in the
thank
house.
Thank you.
Now, you guys might have noticed, but Curtis isn't your normal cowboy.
Why?
Well, he wears red shirts.
Oh.
Yeah, he's like a clamper.
Yeah.
A clamper, yes.
Okay. Now, Curtis, how long you been playing the country music?
About 21 years.
21 years?
Yes.
Well, what did you do before that?
Life insurance. And studied the history of folk music, country music, and blues.
Now, what turned you on to the country music?
Clovis, California. I worked 32 years for the Equitable Life, got transferred to Fresno, bought a home in Clovis. And I grew up watching cowboys like Roy Rogers, Gene Autry, so I started dressing like a cowboy, and I said, well, a cowboy needs to play the guitar, so I took up guitar lessons.
What about riding a horse? Do you ride a horse?
Well, I'm what they call a Coca-Cola cowboy. I dress like one. That's for the movies, you know, movie cowboy. Okay. But I don't shoot guns very well, nothing against guns, and I can't ride a horse. Nothing against horses.
Right.
So I'm one of those Hollywood cowboys, not the real one.
Were you down at the big the rodeo in Clovis?
Well, I had a job that on that particular Sunday, so I was booked that weekend.
So people hire you out to come play their parties and stuff?
Hire me out for private parties and also churches. I do, and that's what I'm going to feature today. Last month, we featured the secular music on the history of country music, and this time we're going to, gospel music is a big part of the history too. We're going to do that part. And I perform this program for churches throughout the Fresno, California, for Love Offering, and each song is a miniature sermon.
So you mean you don't get paid?
I get paid, yes.
In love?
Well, Love Offering, they pass the collection plate.
Oh, I get it.
And I sell my CDs.
All right.
So I can average about $800 to $1,000.
Okay, so how much?
$800 is about the average.
To $1,000?
Yes.
For playing a church?
If you do good songs. And you have CDs, CD sales,
okay.
Yes.
Okay. All right, so what song are you going to do for us today?
Well, I'm going to do some Hank Williams. One's called One Way Ticket to the Sky, to Heaven, and Dust on the Bible. And another one called Build Me a Cabin in the Corner of Glory Land.
All right, Curtis
Here we
Alexander,
go.
Everybody.
Here's One Way Ticket to the Sky. When we hear old Gable's trumpet blow, and we know the hand of God is surely nigh, my new hallelujah song I'll sing, shouting praises to the King. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. And happy, oh happy am I. Walk with Jesus in the Holy Land, shake my dad and mother's hand. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. Soon the pearly gates will open wide, and the Savior will lead us safe inside. God will wipe away our tears, no more sorrows, no more fears. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. And happy, oh happy am I. Walk with Jesus in the Holy Land, shake my dad and mother's hand. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. There's a mansion waiting for me there, that my Savior has built for me on high. How the tears of joy now flow as I gladly onward go. I got my one-way ticket to the sky. Thank you. Now here's one called, Once You Get Up to Heaven, Build Me a Cabin in the Corner of Glory Land. It's not asking for much, not a big mansion.
Many years I've been looking for a place to call home, but I failed here to find it, so I must travel on. I don't care for fine mansions on earth's aching sand. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land, in the shade of the tree of life that it may ever stand, where I can just hear the angels sing and shake Jesus' hand. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land. Blessed Lord, I'm not asking to live in the mist, 'cause I know I'm not worthy of such splendor as this. But I'm asking for mercy while humbly I stand. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land, in the shade of the tree of life that it may ever stand, where I can just hear the angels sing and shake Jesus' hand. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land. I have many loved ones who've gone on this way. On that great and final morning shall I hear them say, come and join in the singing and play in our band. Lord, build me a cabin in the corner of glory land.
Thank you, thank you. Get this capo out. This one's called Dust on the Bible. So the message here is get the dust off the Bible and redeem your poor soul. Or as Hank Williams would say, redeem your poor soul.
I went into a home one day to see some friends of mine. Of all their books and magazines, not a Bible could I find. I asked them for the Bible. When they bought it, what a shame. For the dust was covered over it, not a fingerprint was plain. Dust on the Bible, dust on the Holy Word, the words of all the prophets and the sayings of our Lord. Of all the other books you find, there's none salvation holds. Get the dust off the Bible and redeem your poor soul. Oh, you can read your magazines of love and tragic things, but not one word of Bible verse, not a scripture do you know. When it is the very truth and its content's good for you, but if dust is covered over it, it is sure to doom your soul. Dust on the Bible, dust on the Holy Word, the words of all the prophets and the sayings of our Lord. Of all the other books you'll find, there's none salvation hold. Get the dust off the Bible and redeem your poor soul. Oh, if you have a friend you like to help along life's way, just tell him that the good book shows the mortal how to pray. The best advice to give him that will make his burdens light is to dust the family Bible, trade the wrong way for the right. Dust on the Bible, dust on the Holy Word, the words of all the prophets and the sayings of our Lord. Of all the other books you'll find, there's none salvation holds. Get the dust off the Bible and redeem your poor soul.
Thank you, thank you.
This segment brought to you. All right, welcome back to The Buzz, everybody. I'm your host, Chuck Leonard. Here with me now, Cowboy Curtis Alexander. How's it going, buddy?
Going great.
Yeah, you having fun today?
Having fun.
It's always good to have you around. I got to tell you, that first set of country gospel, pretty impressive.
Ah, thank you.
Are you going to do some more this time?
We'll continue with some, yes.
What are you going to play for us this time?
Well, Luke the Drifter, that's what they call Hank Williams Sr. when he recorded his gospel song.
They called Hank Williams Luke the Drifter. Why?
Yeah. They didn't want, the record label thought it would be bad for his secular business, so.
Oh.
But the public knew it was Hank. But
so he would record under a different name when he did gospel.
Yes.
Oh, very interesting.
Luke the Drifter. We'll continue with some Luke the Drifter songs. And here's one that Hank wrote. It's called I Saw the Light. That's probably one of his most famous ones. And always tells stories behind the songs. This is before Hank made it big. He was always asleep in the back seat of the car. So they were coming from a local concert in Montgomery, and his wife said, "Hank, wake up. We're almost home. I can see lights at the airport." And he wrote, "I saw the light."
Okay, Curtis Alexander, everybody.
And here's how it goes. "I saw the light." "I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrows in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like the blind man, I wandered alone. Worries and fears I claim for my own. Then like the blind man, when God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrows in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I was a fool to wander and stray. Straight is the gate and narrow's the way. Now I have traded the wrong for the right. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrows in sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light." Here's one called "The Book of Life" that Hank wrote. This song is a very powerful song. If I can remember the lyrics. "In life's many battles that you will have to fight, just stay close to Jesus and journey in his light. Then on that judgment morning, when all pain is fled, you'll stand there in God's kingdom when the book of life is read. When the seals are broken and names are read aloud, you'll see many loved ones standing in the crowd. So brother, keep on praying and follow where you're led. United in God's kingdom when the book of life is read. All your dreams of heaven will come through on that day. When the sky shall open and his dirt melt away, then all God's faithful children will raise up from the dead. United in God's kingdom when the book of life is read. What a happy feeling to know you're always there. And when our work is over, heaven with him we'll share. There'll be no pain, no sorrow, no tears will ever be shed. United in God's kingdom when the book of life is read. All your dreams of heaven will come through on that day. When the sky shall open and his dirt melt away, then all God's faithful children will raise up from the dead. United in God's kingdom when the book of life is read." Here's one Hank didn't write. He picked this song up from an old black Baptist minister in Kentucky. It's called "When God Dips His Hand of Love in My Heart." "When God dips his hand of love in my heart and writes my soul a message he wants me to know, his spirit so divine fills this sinful soul of mine. When God dips his love in my heart, I said I wouldn't tell it to a living soul how he bought salvation when he made me whole. I found I couldn't find such love that Jesus did impart. It makes me laugh and it makes me cry, sets my sinful soul on fire. When God dips his love in my heart, he walked every step of Calvary's rugged way, and he gave his life completely to bring a better day. My soul was lost in sin, but in love he took me in. His blood washed all my sins away. I said I wouldn't tell it to a living soul. How he bought salvation when he made me whole. I found I couldn't hide such love that Jesus did impart. It makes me laugh and it makes me cry. Sets my sinful soul on fire when God dips his love in my heart.